Hello, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, where today we're going to be exploring this divine beast here. Now, this is another episode in which I had to re-record the audio, and I used my amiibos before this episode, got the Cap of the Wind, so that's two pieces of the Wind Waker set, which is nice. But yeah, audio is being re-recorded, but unlike the previous couple episodes, this one I'm leaving unedited. So you can actually see my entire dungeon experience. Now, since this is an eye that we can target, I figure this is a Zelda game and you're supposed to put arrows into eyes. Sure enough, that is indeed the solution. And then I take a look around, notice that little guardian-like thing. But don't pay any heed to it until it actually starts moving towards us. So it tries to fire a laser at us. I try to reflect it. Don't manage to do it quite right there. Too early that time. But we're keeping on trying. Again, probably a little too early. And finally we manage it, and it takes it out in one hit. Feels nice. So, we know we have to get in there for the map, and there's another eye thing down here. At first I thought it was reflected from up above, but no, it's actually beneath the water's surface. But easily dealt with. So now, I realize that, hey, this is still closed, but it looks like there's a little bit of clearance. So, I guess I didn't notice that at the time. So we continue on looking for another path, seeing if maybe there's a switch somewhere that can open that door. I start wondering what this stuff is and why it didn't disappear when I broke the eye over there. But figure, hey, the door was over some water, so perhaps, just perhaps. And sure enough, Cryonis does in fact work, and we get to get in and get our map. And so we get to watch yet another map-getting scene that is unskippable, as are all map-getting scenes. And it seems we have controls to this divine beast, which is interesting. So I start thinking, hey, it looks like there's some water wheels inside, and maybe we'll reposition the trunk
map of the divine beast
so that we can turn them.
You will see several glowing points on your map, which represent the terminals that control Ruta. Take Ruta back by activating all of the terminals. Be careful.
And now we have our goal for this dungeon. So at this point I'm realizing that the 3D map of Varuta in the bottom right, the 3D minimap, is not the most useful. I mean, it lets you know where you and other things are relative to the entire thing, but you don't really get a good idea of exactly where you or anything else is. So here I decide to see whether or not we can control Varuta from outside the map room, and sure enough we can, and we even get to watch the trunk move on the minimap, which is kind of neat. So I decide to look up and see if there's any water in fact being sprayed in, and sure enough there is, and it looks like it even turns that water wheel. So indeed, the controls do allow us to do exactly what I was thinking they would. So there's a terminal there. Looks like we gotta spin this crank to raise it up. So, first I try using Cryonis, but you can't put it under the crank. And then I realize, hey, it looks kind of metallic, so yep, sure enough. We just gotta give it a spin. And luckily, I decided to, started spinning it the right way from the start. And Link fails to actually get onto the platform, but that's okay.
There are four terminals remaining. Don't give up.
And so that's one terminal down. Seems there's another terminal inside that water wheel. Down here, we've got what looks like a giant terminal, and also this room seems very bossy, considering how big and open it is relative to everything else. So I assume at this point that if we go too far in, we might fight a boss, which would be weird, but nope, no boss just yet. And since we haven't activated all the terminals, we can't activate that. So I assume at this point that when we go back with all the terminals activated, a boss will indeed show up in there. So now we gotta go look for a way to get to the other terminals, and I remember that there was in fact a ramp over here. And out of curiosity, I decided to see whether or not touching those would indeed hurt, and sure enough, it did. So here we've got another little sentry guy. But he doesn't have too much health. Eat some apples to get our health back. Realize I've got 52 raw meat. Take a look over here, see if there's anything to be seen, and sure enough, there's a ball that goes into a slot on the big water wheel, and that seems to open up access to another terminal. But then, as the wheel keeps going, the ball slides on out of that slot and closes access. So I tried to get up on top of that there, but didn't quite work that time. And then, take another look down, still nothing to see. Decide to see what's out here. We've got another ramp with a mouth thing. And I figure, hey, maybe we're supposed to toss a bomb into that mouth. That's something we've done in Zelda games before. But the mouth does not, in fact, eat the bombs. Makes me a little sad. So I figure maybe there's something else we're supposed to do elsewhere. And since we just broke a weapon, I decide to go pick up that guardian sword that we passed up earlier. So I figure maybe I got my throw wrong, but no. So, still the thing died. I had no clue why, but I wasn't complaining. So now we appear to be on a path to the middle of the big water wheel. And I start trying to puzzle out what we're supposed to do, because that opens up well before we can actually get into it, and it closes again also before we can get into it. And then there's that chest that seems to be trapped between two stones. And I figure, hey, maybe they're magnetic? Nope. Nothing here is magnetic. And so, we must think of another plan. Take a look over there, see what's going on the other water wheel. Because maybe the two are related. And I'm just trying to puzzle out what we're meant to do here. And then it hits me. Stasis can keep things in place. So, if we use stasis on this thing, right before it leaves its socket, maybe we'll be able to get in with the terminal. And so, I hop in while we're still able because it looks like it'll close before we get the chance to actually just walk in. And we manage to activate our terminal.
There are three terminals remaining. You can do it.
And then it stays open once activated, regardless of the fact that the ball has left the socket, which is nice of it. So now I want the chest. So I stasis that top block, or at least what will become the top block. But I used stasis a little bit too early. It runs out before we can actually get the chest. And so we get to wait for it to go around once more. Take a look around, see if there's anything else to be seen. See an interesting looking something over there. But at this point, not sure what it is. So there goes the ball. I use that as a point of reference for when things start to fall. And then I wait for the blocks to get there. And it starts going a little earlier than expected, but we stop it in time anyway. And thus, the chest is ours. And it's a decent reward. And so it seems we're done with the inside of this particular water wheel. I take one last look to be absolutely sure. And then I make a break for... Well, I look up there first, I guess. Think that maybe there's some way to get onto the water wheel to get up there, but... It's spinning the wrong way, and then I remember, hey, I can manipulate this trunk. Maybe I can get it to spin the other way if I put it elsewhere. So I think, hey, if I put it all the way down, maybe it'll spin a different way, or it'll stop, and then we can just walk over it. So I watch as it goes. I notice that, yes, it does spin the other way before it stops. So we now know that we have total control over this water wheel. And I put the trunk where I think it might still spin the way we want it to go. Wait for the trunk to move, and nope, no water coming through. And so then I figure, hey, maybe there's a reason these little notches are separated farther than the others seem to be. Maybe it's to actually give us a little bit of signposting as to where to put the trunk, and sure enough, it is. So now we've got the water wheel spinning in a way that lets us get to the higher areas, provided we get onto the water wheel first. And so, I consider doing just that, but then I actually notice that there seems to be stuff in places. So I take a look, see if there's anything creating that goop. Wait for the wheel to go around. Ready to strike at anything that might be creating that goop. But it seems that no such thing exists. It's just goop that's there for the sake of being there. So we hop on up here. Figure I'll let it carry me over towards this other side here. Use it to get the chest. Take a look down, see it's the area I assumed was a boss area. Get a little bit pleased, about 100 rupees. And then, figure, hey, there's gotta be something we can do to stop this water wheel, considering there's a terminal inside it. Maybe we just gotta get on it and use it? No, it's definitely gotta stop. But I figure, hey, let's try once more. Maybe if we get onto it when it's coming down this side, we'll be able to use it without needing to stop it. And nope, we end up swimming before we can use the terminal. So maybe right when it comes out of the water? Nope. It's still at the wrong angle, so yes, we must stop the water wheel. So maybe stasis will do it. Nope, can't stasis nothing. So maybe we can freeze that thing. So it looks like we can, so I wait. And sure enough, it's frozen, and we can use the thing. Also, it seems to have lowered the water level.
Two terminals remaining. You're nearly there.
Which is convenient, because if it hadn't, we wouldn't have actually been able to use the terminal at that position. So now we need to get onto the other water wheel. Thankfully, it's nice and easy. And then we ride this thing up. I start getting a little concerned that maybe the water from the trunk hitting this thing will blow me off, but I notice there's an eye, so I decide to shoot that first. And then try and get the chest while it's still not too late. Seems the water doesn't actually do anything to us. But unfortunately, we have gone too far and cannot get up where we want to be just yet. And so we have to go back to the upper level of this elephant. I notice that this stuff is still here, despite the fact that we've killed all nearby eyes that we know about. But seems that the stuff isn't tied to any of them. So now we want to get back up there, but there was also that chest that... Wait, we just opened the chest. That's right. So we just want to get up. And again, the water does nothing, despite it being a direct hit. You'd think that with that volume of water, Link would experience some ill effects, but... Nope. So... Notice there's a button. Don't know what it does. Decide to look around first. And then give it a press. And that creates a waterfall, and... I remember that we're allowed to swim up waterfalls with our Zora armor. And I thought I saw something orange glowing through the waterfall, so I got hung up on that a little bit. Decided to look for ways to get under it, but don't see any, so go this way. And come face to face with the raised trunk. with a chest all the way at that end of it. But it seems we can't get there. So we lower the trunk. And then we get to watch it go, which is kind of neat. It's way faster than I expected. Get a little bit wet there. And then we just head on over to where that chest is. Of course, we've got to shoot the eye, so we do exactly that. And then I decide to take a photo of this skull. And it's a cursed Lizalfos. And I thought it was just going to be like a bubble. Because floating skulls in Zelda games have typically been called bubbles. So, there's a chest here. Kinda want it. But I noticed that the rest of the trunk is a bit too steep for us to actually climb. We cannot get up to where we need to be. Which has me confused, because the trunk is as low as it can go. So I figure there must be some other solution. Maybe if we raise the trunk, something good would happen, but... no, that can't be the case, could it? Well, it's worth a shot. Maybe we can hang on, or maybe we can get over here and the trunk will somehow wrap back around to just where we need it to be, or worst case, we can just get back inside. So, I get back inside. As it seems, nope, that doesn't look climbable. So I figure there must be some other way to get higher up. And I decide to search for just such a way. So maybe if we jump up on these little bits on the side, we can get to where we need to be. But no, it's too high. We can't climb up there. What about the other side? This at least seems to have a platform below it, so I think maybe this is somewhere we're supposed to go. Can't really tell where we are from the map, because it's too clear and too... it's too cluttered with everything. And it seems this platform exists for no reason. And so we get off of it. I move the trunk to where we can get back up to the upper level once again. And then we get going. I don't recall having gone out that little door there, so I'm considering going for it, but we're already over here, so why not take another look around, see if there's anything we've missed. Sure enough, there is a platform higher up. I'm not certain how to get to it, so I think maybe we swim up the trunk's waterfall, or maybe we swim up this waterfall. Because it did launch us quite a bit, and hey, look, there's a chest in the water. Kinda want that. And so, we whip out our trusty magnet. Sure enough, it's a metal chest. So I figure this must have been the orange glow that I spotted in the waterfall before, because it doesn't seem like there's any platforms or anything to have had an orange glow on them. Look on the other side, see if there's any chest over there. No dice. And then we try swimming up the waterfall. I really wish we could swim that fast going horizontally and not just vertically. But alas. And we get this chest. We don't seem to have gone quite high enough to get to whatever else was up there. So I figure, hey, maybe if we go over here now, we can swim up the water stream. But no. And it looks like there's fire over there. That seems weird. So I'm just thinking of ways I could possibly get up there. And nothing's coming to mind. So I think, hey, maybe if we put out the fire with this water, it'll open a path. And so I move the trunk, but it seems nothing's happening. Maybe we need to move it down one more tick to put out the fire. But again, the trunk moves and nothing happens. One more tick. Surely this is it, right? No, not right. The fire remains. So maybe if we lower the trunk almost all the way. But then no, the water's got to go out forward instead of up onto the elephant itself. So I figure let's lower the trunk all the way, and then we can try and climb out onto it. Maybe have it lift us up. But first, we'll try swimming up the waterfall one more time. Maybe I just didn't pull out my glider at the right time. But no, we definitely cannot glide over to there. Maybe if we shoot at the fire with an ice arrow, it'll get put out. I decide to try that from my glider at the top of this waterfall. But no, we don't quite have the range. And I drowned at the bottom because I used up all my stamina aiming. Decide to try one more time, maybe if we aim higher. So I aim up a ways, but I let go too late, and we drown again. Swap over to regular arrows so that I don't accidentally waste any ice arrows. Decide to try just one more time. Maybe I can shoot the eye up top instead of shooting the flames, but no, definitely don't have the range for that. So I try and glide and successfully manage not to drown this time. So maybe if we go over here, we can get somewhere useful. Nope, that's a dead end, not a path up. So it seems there's no way on the inside of this elephant to get up there. So surely I must be missing something. Maybe if we have the elephant spin this water wheel the other way. Thinking at this point, maybe this'll let me actually go up the water stream to the top of the trunk. Because it's more cohesive. Or maybe we can use stasis to freeze the water or something. But no, none of this seems to be at all effective. I try making a block there just because it looks like we can, considering the bright blue, but Nope. Just because the water is bright blue doesn't mean we can actually freeze it. So maybe if we use an ice arrow there, it'll freeze it and make a path. But nope, the arrow does not go far enough. Maybe if we freeze the stream itself. But no, the arrow goes right through. Maybe if we get higher and take our shot. But no, we can't get to where we want to be. I decide to get some health here. Why not? And so this time we swim on up. Try to climb this wall, but of course it is unclimbable. As is that one. As are all walls inside this dungeon. Maybe if we glide over to here, we can find a new place to walk to or something. But no. So, now I decide to lower the trunk all the way. And then see if maybe I missed some way to get to the tip of it. So here we are, glide over there just to try and move faster, and then realize, hey wait, the trunk is way lower, we could have just done this from the start. And I start berating myself for missing such a simple solution, decide to raise the trunk up, because this should be how we get to the terminal on the trunk, and sure enough it is. So we just kind of stand here and wait for it to be usable.
Just one terminal remaining.
Now we just have the one left. So I notice there's a chest over here. And I do want it. But it seems to be protected. So I start looking for the source of the goop, spot an eye over on the other side. But it seems we're not on the right side for it. But from here we can glide down to where we saw fire before. So here we've got another mouth thing. This one's spitting out moblin skulls that really like to avoid my sword. And there's just a cursed bokoblin. That's nothing. Though it did hit me, and then there's another. And try to take a photo of the mouth thing, but looks like it doesn't actually get registered into our creature list thing. I figure, hey, maybe what killed the last one was I just killed all of the skulls it could spit out. So I kill some skulls. No dice. Maybe we throw the bomb into it. Still no dice. Maybe a jump attack, but no. And then I realize there's that eye still looking at us. Maybe we can take a photo of that, but no. Yep, definitely not something that goes into our catalog. So let's just shoot it. get rid of these skulls. And hey, the mouth thing is gone. And I spy another crank. And so we give it a spin. Start off trying to go the wrong way this time. And it looks like it opens up the roof, which means we might be able to get some water in here to douse the fire after all. I keep spinning it, thinking that maybe it'll open wider or maybe we're on a timed thing. But it looks like that's not the case. So we put the trunk where it needs to be. And then we wait. Sure enough, water comes through here, and it puts out the flames, giving us access to the final terminal.
You activated all the terminals. Now you can start the main control unit. There should be a new glowing mark on your map. Head there. Be careful not to let your guard down.
And I figure I'll head there, but there's still a chest we have to get. And also, now that we've got an open weapon slot, we can grab this as well. And so we lower the trunk so that we may once again glide over to the tip and climb on up. Well, not so much climb on up as ride it on up. And we bring the trunk all the way up. Decide to try standing on this to see if anything happens, and sure enough, nothing does. But I waited too long! We're stuck! But we just barely managed to get up here. And so I glide over to where I can shoot this eye. Decide to try taking a photo here because it is closer, but still nothing. And so we give it a shot. And sure enough, that does clear away the stuff from the chest on the other side. Problem is, we're on this side, and I don't want to actually have to go all the way to the tip of the trunk again and ride it up. So I think, hey, maybe there's another way over. So, let's give it a shot. And we appear to be stuck here, but I'm not ready to give up just yet. Because if we start gliding from the peak, maybe we can get up onto that. And sure enough, it's doable. Then we can climb on up here and make it to where the chest is. And with that, I'm fairly certain we've gotten all the chests in this dungeon. Decide to take one last look around, see if there's any orange glows to be spotted. And then down we go. Because we have what I assume to be a boss ready for us to fight. Eat some mushrooms to heal up beforehand. And in we go. Now, no boss has attacked us yet, so maybe once we either get up to the thing or try to use it. And that can't be good. And here I'm thinking this thing has some sort of natural defenses that we need to overcome. But that doesn't look like something natural. Unless we get Water Blight Ganon, who I am very concerned will cause our stamina to regenerate more slowly than usual.
That thing is one of Ganon's creations. I put up as much of a fight as I could, but it proved to be my demise 100 years ago. Regardless, I believe that you are well prepared for this moment. I have faith in you.
And now we've got a boss to fight. So we're told the spear has a long reach. So I figure, hey, maybe we shoot it in the glowy eye, because that's really obvious, and it does decent damage. More damage than shooting its arm, but then we get this flurry rush going on. That's pretty nice. And it looks like it's collapsed, so we get to just keep going. Get a lot of damage in on that first phase. Looks like only two more of those and we'll just straight up win. So I try shooting it in the eye. Try a backflip, but am not able to time it right that time. So just shoot the eye some more and hey, it's knocked down again. And it seems we've got a second phase. So we've got to get onto one of these platforms, and then it starts off right above us, which doesn't seem great. So I try and move, and then get taken out by an ice block. So we must try again. And so, in we go. Thankfully, it's not a long walk. So I decide to change to a higher damage weapon, just to try and get rid of it faster. And we get rudely interrupted here by this thing just happening to spawn behind us. So I figure, hey, let's eat a couple roasted bass, that'll heal us up to full. And let's get back to shooting. Try a side hop, doesn't work. Eat some more bass. Shoot the eye a couple times, or just once. Again, side hop doesn't work. At this point, I was still operating under the assumption that any jump would count for a perfect dodge, but apparently you do need to jump in specific ways. And so we shoot the eye some more. Have a baked apple. That time, we got our jump for the flurry rush. And so we get to just go to town. But we're still not quite in phase two yet. So I figure, hey, get another flurry rush. Maybe we'll get to do a lot of damage before phase two, but nope. This time, we are directly above a platform, so we won't start off swimming, which will be a bit of an advantage here.
Careful. Not much room to operate.
Okay. And now he's using his ice block, so I figure, hey, we can maybe perfect dodge it, but no. And that thing does 3 hearts of damage to us in one hit. It's a little painful. So we get back up. This time I shoot it, because that's worked before, and sure enough, it works this time. Shoot the guy in the eye. But then he does this. I lament the fact that I don't have any cooked foods that I can use for more hearts that don't also super overheal us, so we eat some shrooms, but only just enough to not quite fully heal us. Don't want to do any overhealing at this point because we are fairly low on curatives, or at least non-meat curatives, which at this point I think I was concerned might give Link stomach problems. So we shoot the eye a couple times, we take a spear to the face, double fist some mushrooms, get back up, notice that it seems to be moving from platform to platform in a counterclockwise fashion. So I figure after it disappears here, we're gonna have to move to the next platform over. Give it another couple shots, and hey, it falls down! So let's get over there and get smacking. And sure enough, it didn't like that, but we need to equip another weapon. So I figure, hey, this broadsword will do fine. It'll probably move to the next platform, but no, it goes back there, so it doesn't go in a cycle. And now it wants to laser us, so I decide to just hide over here, but almost get back up into its range. And now it moves directly above where we were, which causes problems because I assume it's going to try and laser us again, but it doesn't. Thankfully, one of its ice blocks got broken by the wall. And now we get to just shoot its eye. And one more shot, and we win. And at this point, I realized I forgot to take a photo of it. So I'm hoping either we get to have a rematch at some point, or we can buy a photo of it from someone at some point. Also, the fact that it's spraying all that purple gunk everywhere doesn't seem like it's good for this place, but I guess it's fine. And now we are freely able to activate that thing. And hey, look, a free heart container. Didn't even have to do 4 shrines for this one. So of course I'm gonna grab it. At first I thought I'd just walk into it, but no, you actually gotta press a button. And now we have 5 hearts. But this episode's been fairly long, and I figured there would probably be a cutscene if we activated that, so saving that for next episode. Join us next time to see it. See you then, friends.